Welcome you all for the today's class. In the previous class we have discussed about the combinational circuits. Okay, so that comes in your module 5 of basic electronics. In combinational circuit, what happens? It is depending on the present inputs. Okay, it is depending on the present input. Whatever input you are going to supply for the circuit, that is going to be evaluated and then will give the output. But what is happen in your sequential circuit, it is going to depend on the present input and the previous output. Okay, so that is what the difference between the combinational circuit and the sequential circuit. So if I take the sequential circuit in detail, okay, so basically I told you the output is going to depend on the both the present inputs and the previous outputs. If you take the diagram, the circuit of the sequential circuit, all the sequential circuits, so there will be a memory element, okay, so then followed by the combinational logic circuits. Okay, so before you make any evaluation in the combinational circuit, you are going to take the feedback from the combinational circuit and you have to keep it in your memory, and then you have to do this continuously till the clock is going to be present. Okay, so the clock is, so till where the clock is going to have, so this particular circuit is continuously working. Okay, as basically what you are seeing here, the flip flops, so these are the memory element, and these flip flops are going to be changed its state for every cycle, and these changes are going to propagate to the combinational logic circuit. Okay, this is going to be propagated with the help of this changes in the state. Okay, and finally these combinational circuits and the logic gates, okay, these are going to be become stable after the one rotation. So this is going to be cycle is going to be repeat again and again till you stop the clock. Okay, so this particular process is going to be happen again and again. So if you take the examples of the flip flops, so we are going to study the different flip flops like SR flip flop, JK flip flop, D flip flop and T flip flop. Okay, we are going to study these all flip flops in detail for the next class. Okay, and we are going to have the examples for the sequential circuit as a shift registers. We are going to shift the data from one for every clock cycle, it is going to shift it by one position. So that you are going to see here, and this is going to be constructed with the help of flip flop only, and the counters. Okay, it's going to count either up or down. So depending on the construction or the circuit. Okay, and these counters also the build with the help of flip flop. So these two will be considered as the applications of the flip flop. Okay, this is all about the basics of the sequential circuit. So we'll take one by one the flip flops explanation for the next. Thank you.